Slate call. Not as popular as the oncoming popularity of mouth calls, still, however, it remains one of the easiest, purest sounding turkey calls that exist. However, they also take the most maintenance to keep them sounding good. Slate calls are susceptible to moisture or oil from your hands, and if the surface gets slick, it will sound absolutely horrible if you get any sound out of it at all. So the goal is to keep as much friction as possible between the striker and the slate. One of the ways you can do that is to use a Scotch-Brite pad on the slate to roughen it up a little bit. Understand, smooth is the enemy to good sound. Also, don't forget to work your striker. Some 220 or 240 grit sandpaper works well to roughen that up so that you gain that good friction. Do this, and you're sure to draw in those big toms looking for that desperate hen. You know, when I think of cleaning slates, I also think of our standing before God. First, we need to understand that we all have marks against us, don't we? Marks on all the slate of our life. If you've hunted very long, you've certainly missed before. I have, just recently. It's embarrassing. Maybe you're wondering, how can you clean your slate before God, knowing that you've missed the mark before Him? Well, Scripture certainly confirms that. It tells us in Romans chapter 3, verse 23, these words, "For all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God." That is, we have missed the mark, and we're in desperate shape. Because of that, God, who is a just, holy, righteous God, must punish sin. And He declares the wages of sin is death, not just physical death, but a spiritual death that will bring everlasting punishment and separation from God. But you know what? There's good news. That is, someone was sent to clean our slate. No, not this one. The slate of our lives. Because of what Jesus did in dying for us, we can be declared not guilty, clean, new, just as if I'd never sinned before, justified, with a clean slate, where God as the judge declares us not guilty. The Bible describes that Jesus, in cleaning our slate, gives us a new life. It's just like the way I clean this one. Or a chalkboard. If I was really called to get everything off of it, I would wash it too. Well, He washes us clean. Washes us so that we can have a new life. It's a promise that we can all gain in Jesus. We still miss the mark occasionally, but when we get it right with a clean slate and He goes to work on us, it sure ends up in a sweet sound before our Maker. That's my time. Thanks for your time. Until next time.